So, you are present in the last class.
Hello.
So, you are present in the last class?
Yes, sir.
Runal? Doin, you were present in the last class?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Swarm. Today, I think I can start now. Can I start? This is going to be your these labs next experiment. Okay, the first part of this experiment today you will start here, and that experiment will be the study of Hall effect experiment. Okay, now this experiment you have to do it two ways. There are two steps. First part. You have to be acquainted with the zero error adjustment in this experiment. What is zero error? In the last class, were acquainted with the zero error of screw gauge and slide caliper zero error concept. You have got the idea of this in this experiment of study of Hall effect. You have to, you have to consider and understand the zero error adjustment for a voltage measuring equipment. In a voltmeter, you have to make the zero error adjustment. Here, so Abhishek, what you are going to do? Today, the name of the experiment is study of Hall effect, and before doing that, you have to first clear how to adjust the zero error of any equipment. Here, Abhishek, what you are going to do? Aritro.
Yes, sir.
What you are going to do?
Sir, we are going to measure the zero error of an instrument.
Okay, of a voltmeter. And then using that concept, you have to do one experiment, that is study of Hall effect. Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Now, All of you can hear me clearly. Hello? Kunal, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Nandini? Can you hear me?
Yes,
sir. So, what you are going to do, first of all, you have to adjust the zero error of an electric equipment. Okay. And you have to impart the concept of adjusting zero error of an instrument. Then, instrument means here it is a voltmeter. Okay. Then you will perform the experiment. What is experiment name? It will be study of Hall effect. What is study of Hall effect? Means Hall voltage. Means Now, is there anyone outside yet? So, so from the beginning, okay, suppose you have a current carrying semiconductor, okay, piece of semiconductor anywhere, okay, and you are keeping that current carrying semiconductor, you are holding that piece of current carrying semiconductor perpendicularly in a magnetic field. Okay, what is the condition? That is, you are means holding a current carrying semiconductor perpendicularly in a magnetic field. Due to Lorentz force, charge carriers within the semiconductor will get a kind of alignment. That alignment will make positive charges within the semiconductor on one side, negative charges on the opposite side, and it will constitute a voltage. You have to measure these voltages. This is Hall voltage. Okay. I am telling again, that is, when you keep a current carrying semiconductor inside a perpendicular or transverse magnetic field, a voltage will be generated within that semiconductor. Due to Lorentz force, this voltage will be generated, and this Lorentz force will make alignment or of that or polarize your charges within the semiconductor. Ultimately, you will get a voltage within the semiconductor. This is Hall voltage you have to measure. I'm telling again, that is, if anyone keep a current carrying semiconductor perpendicularly, you are holding the piece of current carrying semiconductor in a perpendicular magnetic field, due to Lorentz force, the charge carriers will get a kind of alignment within the semiconductor, and finally you will get a voltage in the semiconductor. That alignment will produce a voltage. This voltage is Hall voltage you have to measure. Okay? So, Paritro, what is Hall voltage? How it's produced?
When we keep a current carrying semiconductor in transverse magnetic field due to Lorentz force,
the charge carriers will be get a kind of alignment within the semiconductor, and a voltage will be alignment generated due to this alignment. This is Hall voltage you have to measure. Kunal,
okay.
What is Hall voltage? Explain. Kunal? Why Hall voltage generates? Kunal? Nandini? Hello? Abhijit?
Yes, sir. Sir, when we put a current carrying,
In your own language, explain. When?
In a current, in a transverse magnetic field, sir, due to Lorentz force, due to Lorentz force.
What is Lorentz force? Can you remember? F equals QB plus B. These QB actually, that current force, which is flowing in form of charges. Okay, when you are flowing that piece, some current through that semiconductor. Isn't it? So, this if QB cross B part generates a magnetic field, sorry, force, that will result the charge carriers, a kind of polarization within the semiconductor, this is Hall effect, Hall voltage. Okay, so, Abhijit, finish.
Yes, sir.
Finish. What you are saying?
Nothing, sir.
Abhijit? Adjita, Arjit,
yes, sir.
What is Hall voltage?
Sir, can you repeat, sir? Sir, can't hear properly.
You can't hear totally. Okay. Means whenever you keep a current carrying semiconductor. You are holding that piece of semiconductor, you are flowing some current through that semiconductor, and you are holding that piece of current carrying semiconductor inside a perpendicular magnetic field due to Lorentz force of voltage will be generated within that semiconductor. That voltage is known as Hall voltage. What I told, what is it?
Sir, the term I can't hear, sir. What voltage?
Okay. Vikram, can you?
Yes, sir.
In your language, explain.
Sir, whenever we keep any current carrying semiconductor in a perpendicular transversal magnetic field, charge carrier should be aligned due to Lorentz force.
And that a voltage will be generated due to this area alignment of these charge carriers. This is called voltage. Vishnu, you? Vishnu?
Yes, sir.
What is Hall voltage?
So if you put current carrying semiconductor in a perpendicular magnetic field, voltage is generated due to Lorentz force. That voltage is called
Chanchal, what is Hall voltage? How generate is get generated? Chanchal? Joy?
Yes, sir.
What is Hall voltage?
When we are passing, when we are flowing current from a semiconductor and we are putting perpendicular I can't remember.
Means whenever you put a current carrying semiconductor inside a perpendicular magnetic field, what will happen? Those charge carriers within the semiconductor, which is you are applying in form of current. Current means charge carriers. They will experience a force, F equals QB equals B. It is Lorentz force, and this Lorentz force will give a kind of alignment within the semiconductor, and finally we will get a voltage. This is Hall voltage. Explain. What is Hall voltage? Now in your own term, explain your what is Hall voltage. When you keep a current carrying semiconductor in a perpendicular magnetic field, okay, or transverse magnetic field, means you are holding a piece perpendicularly, piece of semiconductor perpendicularly in the magnetic field. This is the condition. What is the condition I told? You are?
We are putting
you are holding a piece of current carrying semiconductor in a perpendicular
to the magnetic field.
So what is the condition?
We are keeping current flowing semiconductor perpendicular to the magnetic field.
By your hand you are holding a piece of semiconductor in a perpendicular magnetic field, then what will happen?
Voltage will generate, which is called
areas will experience a force. That force force will make charge carriers will get a kind of polarization or kind of alignment. That alignment will again ultimately give a voltage, that is Hall voltage. You have to measure.
Okay.
So explain what is Hall voltage and how it will generate. Joy? How will you get Hall voltage in your own language? Jeta tomar bhalo mone hobe tumi ye language e bojhao ki kore generate korbe ota. Joy, Joy,
yes sir,
nije explain koro ki kore generate korbe.
আমরা হাতে করে একটা সেমিকন্ডাক্টর ধরছি যেটাতে কারেন্ট ফ্লো হচ্ছে, সেটাকে পারপেন্ডিকুলার রাখছি ম্যাগনেটিক ফিল্ডে, তাতে ট্রান্সভার্স কিছুগুলো চার্জ জেনারেট হচ্ছে যেটার জন্য একটা ভোল্টেজ জেনারেট হবে, আর সেটাকে হল ভোল্টেজ বলা হচ্ছে।
কাঞ্চন, হোয়াট ইজ হল ভোল্টেজ?
স্যার, when we put a current carrying semiconductor in a perpendicular magnetic field due to Lorentz force of Lorentz force of voltage in a voltage in generate.
Okay, Lorentz force ki korbe bolo to charge carrier gulo ke align kore debe jeta current er forme tumi semiconductor er modhe diye pathacho, tai to ta plus gulo ek dike chole jabe, minus gulo ek dike chole jabe. এই ভোল্টেজটাই হচ্ছে হল ভোল্টেজ যেটা তোমরা মেজার করবে।
আচ্ছা, ওকে স্যার।
অভিজিৎ, অভিজিৎ এক্সপ্লেন হোয়াট ইউ আর ডুইং, হাউ হল ভোল্টেজ জেনারেটস।
স্যার, হাউ হল ভোল্টেজ জেনারেট দ্য জেনারেশন অফ হল ভোল্টেজ ইজ,
হ্যাঁ, ইন ইউর ওন ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ, তুমি নিজের ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজে বোঝাও হল ভোল্টেজ কেন জেনারেট করবে বলো। তুমি কি করছো যার জন্য হল ভোল্টেজটা জেনারেট করে বলো।
When we keep a semiconductor, current carrying semiconductor transfers to the perpendicular flow of the current.
Current carrying semiconductor মানে কি বলো তো? এটা কি একটা semiconductor যার মধ্যে দিয়ে কি করছো তুমি আগেই একটা কারেন্ট পাঠাচ্ছ আই, হ্যালো, তারপরে বলো,
which is kept perpendicular to the flow of the current due to the Lorentz force, and the means the charges are aligned due to which the current is flowing through the semiconductor, and therefore the voltage that is generated is known as the Hall voltage.
Abhishek,
sir, when a current carrying conductor, when it is put
semiconductor,
sir, when it is put perpendicular to the flow of current due to Lorentz force, a voltage is created that is called
That is called Hall voltage.
Hall voltage.
Vikram.
Yes, sir.
What is Hall voltage?
Sir, when we keep the current carrying semiconductor in a perpendicular to the magnetic field due to Lorentz force, charge carriers should be aligned due to which voltage is generated.
What makes those charge carriers aligned?
Sir, due to Lorentz force, charge should be aligned. Aligned.
What is Lorentz force? F equals QV cross B, isn't it? This QV,
yes, sir,
is the arcing current which is you are flowing through the semiconductor, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Oshik.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir means.
So when we keep
all voltage. Manob. Manob. What is Hall voltage? DG, what is Hall voltage?
Yes, sir. So when we put a current carrying semiconductor perpendicular to magnetic field due to Lorentz force, voltage is generated, that is called Hall voltage.
Sheila.
Yes, sir.
What is Hall voltage?
So whenever a current carrying semiconductor is put perpendicular to the magnetic field, a voltage is generated. Due to that, the charge carriers get an alignment. This is called Hall voltage.
Sneha.
Yes, sir.
No, I took what I bolo tale. I mean, bol. Ei jaygata ektu complete kore. Tarpor tumi bolo.
Question of the discussion.
Ha ha, ektu boleni. এই 10 মিনিট আমাদের তারপরে বাপ 15 মিনিট তারপরে আবার বাকিটা জিরো এররটা নিয়ে পড়ব ঠিক আছে বা আগে আমি 20 মিনিট বলে নি তার মধ্যে আমার হয়ে যাবে তারপর ওইটা বলো হল কোএফিসিয়েন্টটা কমপ্লিট হয়নি জাস্ট স্টার্ট করলাম ওকে ম্যাম ইজ নাও গিভিং সাম ইনস্ট্রাকশনস ফার্স্ট ফলো দ্যাট দেন আই এম
Dear student, please listen. All of you prepare three copies for your lab. Okay. One copy is like that one. I'm showing it right now. Just like that type of copy. Just check it. This will be your fair copy. Okay. That is Oxford practical copy like that one. All of you, please respond. Is it visible? Which type of copy?
Yes, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Not so okay. Clear, ma'am.
This is just only the practical copy for fair copy. You just check over here. That is Oxford copy, like that one. Okay. That will be your index page. 1 minute. That will be your index page where you have to write first of all serial number. That is the first experiment like that, your determination of the Hall coefficient. You have to write that one, serial number one. Thereafter, you have to write the experiment number and here experiment name. After that, that from which page to up to which page you are writing that experiment, you have to write all of that. And how to write this one? You have to write first of all here the heading, experiment number. Thereafter, experiment name. Then working formula. After that working formula, whatever the manual you will get later regarding that different experiment, you have to write the table in this side, in ruling side, and in that white page, you have to write, listen. in that wife side, you have to draw the diagram and each and every calculation like that. Here, if you write 0.1, here is the 0.1 and here is the multiplication of 32 into 0.001. Whatever the each and every small calculation, you have to show in that white side page. Okay, in that ruling side, you have to write only tables. And after completion of that observation table, in that side, you have to write that final result. Thereafter, calculations, then result, then conclusion. Okay, in this way, you have to write each and every lab experiment. So now, one thing, whenever your first experiment will get completed, and after that, you have to write this one. And in that lab, arbitrarily, I will ask you to show your lab copy. So, three copies you have to keep along with you. If you get a chance to come in the college, okay, suppose physical classes will be when will you get started, then three copies is very necessary for you. One should be Viva copy, like that sir is taking that classes and he is asking some questions. So when he will ask some questions, you write down the questions and thereafter the answers. Okay, that will be your Viva copy. It will also carry marks. Okay, at semester exam, all of you have to submit that copies. Maybe a scan, making a scan, and after that you will submit that copies. Or otherwise, if normal classes will start about, then you have to submit that copies along with your fair copy. And parallel, you have to, when you will perform any experiment, when you will take the data, that's why you need actually one rough copy. That will be only for BSPH 191 for that code. That copy will be for only physics lab. That is physics lab, that paper code is BSPH 191. Okay, and another copy will be that fair copy. After completion of one experiment, you have to write the fair copy. After completion of that fair copy, I will check each and every experiment. You have to show it, or we can say that please submit it. Suppose Arijit, please submit it, or Bikram, please submit it today. Then you have to submit it maybe in Google Classroom or maybe in Gmail through mail. Whatever you will get the instruction in this mode, you have to submit that copies. So be careful about that. You don't think that you are attending the lab from your house. So if I don't take any seriousness, no. You take seriousness from your first lab, okay? Is it clear to all of you? Yes or yes, no? Ma'am. If you have any doubt regarding, if you have any doubt regarding that copies, you can ask me if you have any question. Any questions? No. Okay. Thank you. So, sir will continue that class right now and then I will ask any question to you. Sandeepda, class turn out. Start karo.
So, it was Hall effect. What is Hall effect then? Rohit, can you remember?
Yes, sir. Sir, when we hold a current carrying semiconductor in a perpendicular magnetic field, sir, the charges align due to Lorentz force. Sir, this is and generate a voltage which is called Hall voltage.
Okay. So now, I think, do you have any questions regarding how Hall voltage generates? Means whenever you keep a current carrying semiconductor in a perpendicular magnetic field, Hall voltage will be generated. That is, this is the generation of the Hall voltage. Next, it will be, suppose when means is zero adjustment of this setup. Okay, I think in screw gauge and slide calipers you know what zero error is. Okay, so likewise that these setup also show some zero error. Okay, so what does that zero error means? Means when you will apply some current and you keep the your chip inside a magnetic field, a voltage will generate, you will measure that value on the voltmeter, it will be all voltage you have to measure. But here one more thing will happen, that is when you will not apply any magnetic field and you will take the piece out of the magnetic field, still it will show some less value which should not come, but it will come. This is zero error of that setup of the voltmeter. Here, so I am telling again, that means here in this setup, when you will take your reading, you have to take it when there is a magnetic field and you are keeping your piece of the semiconductor perpendicularly, you will get some Hall voltage. It will be a value which is higher. Okay. But when you will make the setup off and don't allow any current through the semiconductor and magnetic field off, still that voltmeter will show some small reading. That will be zero error of the voltmeter. You have to subtract from that higher value which you will get earlier by keeping the chip inside the magnetic field. Okay, I'm telling again, that is here when you will pass some current through the chip and hold it perpendicularly in the magnetic field, voltmeter will show some reading, that will be all voltage reading. But when you will take it out on the magnetic field, the chip, when you will take them with that chip out, still that voltmeter will show some reading voltage which will be much smaller. This will be zero error of that voltmeter. You have to adjust. So Nidhi, what is zero error of this voltmeter? Is how you will adjust.
Sir, can you explain once again?
Abhijit, anything clear? Anyone have got this thing clear? Adhita, Abhishek? Here, in this setup, you will measure some voltage after keeping your current carrying semiconductor in a perpendicular magnetic field. Some voltage will come, you will measure that, that will be all voltage. Clear up to this? Abhishek? When you keep this semiconductor inside a non-magnetic field, you will get a Hall voltage, you will get the reading. That will be Hall voltage reading you have to measure. Okay. Clear up to this, all of you? Or you have any question? But in this setup, when you are not applying any magnetic field, and when you will take the strip of the semiconductor outside the magnetic field, still that voltmeter will show some lower voltage, very small, but that will show some voltage which should be zero, but it is not zero. It will show some voltage on the voltmeter. Is it clear how this zero error is coming? It is the error of that setup I am talking about. Clear up to this what I am trying to tell? What is it? Any question?
No, sir.
Now explain what is the zero error of this setup? When there is no magnetic field, you will get some very small voltage which should be zero, but it will come some reading. But when you are applying some magnetic field, some higher voltage will come, that will be actually Hall voltage. You have to measure, okay, that value. And when you are keeping the magnetic field zero, still some voltage will come on the voltmeter. Okay, you have to adjust these zero magnetic fields voltage which has came from that voltage which had came earlier for a higher magnetic field at a means some voltage you will get. Okay, means when you are applying some voltage here due to Lorentz force, you will get some Hall voltage reading. Okay, but in your voltmeter instrument you will see that when you are not applying Lorentz force, the voltmeter will show some very small voltage. Means it's zero, it's not at zero. At that time it should be zero, but it will never show zero when you are not allowing any magnetic field and your current is just outside and away from the magnetic field. Still, at that time there should not be any Lorentz forces reading or Hall voltage reading. So the voltmeter reading would have to be zero, but it will not shown zero. This is zero error of the setup. We'll explain what is the zero error. Origit, what is the origin, zero error of this voltmeter setup? You will get proper Hall voltage reading in the proper Hall voltage condition. Okay, but when you are not maintaining the proper Hall voltage value, means you are keeping the magnetic field zero, still some voltage reading will come. Small Hall voltage will come, as if that is the value of the small Hall voltage. It is not Hall voltage, but it is the error in that voltmeter. This is the zero error of that setup. How you will adjust? What is it? What is zero error of this voltmeter setup? And how it will you will omit that, adjust that? What is it? What is it? Clear, honey? আমি বাংলায় বলবো একবার। ধরো প্রথম কন্ডিশনটা কি ছিল বলতো, এখানে হল ভোল্টেজ পাওয়ার, যে তোমরা একটা ম্যাগনেট পারপেন্ডিকুলার ম্যাগনেটিক ফিল্ডে একটা কারেন্ট ক্যারিং সেমিকন্ডাক্টরকে রেখে একটা ভোল্টেজ মেজার করবে, সেই ভোল্টমিটারের রিডিংটা তোমরা পাবে, তোমাদের মেজার করতে হবে। ক্লিয়ার হলো? এটা হচ্ছে ফার্স্ট স্টেপ। কিন্তু যখন তোমরা ম্যাগনেটিক ফিল্ডটাকে জিরো করবে এবং সেমিকন্ডাক্টরটাকে বাইরে রাখবে, তখনও দেখবে একটা খুব ছোট
সো সাম ভোল্টেজ, ইট শুড বি জিরো বাট ইট ডাজ, হ্যাঁ
হ্যাঁ, ইটস নট জিরো, ইট উইল নট নেভার, ইট উইল নট বি জিরো।
ইয়েস স্যার, দ্যাট ইজ কলড জিরো এরর অফ ভোল্টমিটার।
ওকে, হোয়াট ইজ ইট, হোয়াট ইজ জিরো এরর অফ দিস ভোল্টমিটার? অভিজিৎ এক্সপ্লেন করতো এই সেটআপটার জিরো এরর ব্যাপারটা কি?
স্যার, when we do not apply, yes sir, sir after sir taking the values of the readings, sir when we remove the current but still it shows some voltage, sir, sir due to sir some defective piece in the voltmeter, sir it shows some values where which should be zero but it isn't zero, sir, that is called zero error, sir, which should be corrected by subtracting that from the value that had already come, sir, so we can correct that.
Okay, Abhishek, what is the zero error of this setup?
Sir, when you when we keep semiconductor in non-magnetic field where
voltage is when the current carrying semiconductor in a perpendicular magnetic field
তুমি যখন রাখবে তখন কি হবে? মানে ভোল্টেজ রিডিং পাবে। ওকে, হ্যাঁ, তুমি কি করবে ওই ভোল্টেজ রিডিংটা নিয়ে, তারপরে কি করবে তুমি সেটআপটাকে, যদি তুমি ম্যাগনেটিক ফিল্ডের পাশ থেকে তুমি যদি ইনস্ট্রুমেন্টটাকে বার করে আনো চিপটাকে, দেখবে আরেকটা স্লাইট ভোল্ট স্মলার ভোল্টেজ শো করছে ভোল্টমিটারে, সেটা কিন্তু জিরো হওয়ার কথা ছিল, ওটা জিরো হবে না, এটা হচ্ছে জিরো এরর ভোল্টেজ,
জিরো এরর।
ওকে
ওকে স্যার, তো
কি করে অ্যাডজাস্ট করবে বলো
স্যার? ওটা হ্যাঁ স্যার, একটা স্যার জিরো সাবস্ট্রাক্ট যোগ অ্যাড করলে যোগ হয়ে যাবে।
অ্যাড না, ওটা সাবট্রাক্ট করতে হবে তোমাকে ওই
ভাই, হ্যাঁ সাবস্ট্রাক্ট
ম্যাগনেটিক ফিল্ড সো ইট জেনারেটস দ্য হল ভোল্টেজ and we can measure this in a voltmeter, and there is some problem in the setup that instead of coming in that zero we'll get some voltage but in not passing the current, so by subtracting this value from the original one we can get the original that is exact value of the voltage.
Rohit, what is zero error voltage? How will we adjust that? Rohit, Sheila, what is zero error voltage? Explain.
Sir, when we are not applying any magnetic field but still there is some reading in the voltmeter, that is called zero error voltage.
And what is exact voltage then?
Sir, when the magnetic field is applied, then the voltage appears, that is called Hall voltage.
But it's appeared voltage, it's not exact. What is the exact voltage? It will be that appeared voltage minus the zero error voltage.
This okay, sir.
What else you have to make? Okay.
Okay,
so,
sir.
Explain what is exact Hall voltage.
Sir, appeared voltage is the exact Hall voltage we got minus the zero error voltage.
Good. Shubham, explain. What is the exact Hall voltage you have to measure?
Sir?
What is the exact Hall voltage you have to measure in any reading on this setup?
Sir, we can read the exact voltage by subtracting the Hall voltage minus by the error voltage, sir.
Good.
Zero error
voltage. Shomo, what is exact Hall voltage? Tomar nijer language e bolo. Sneha, bolo.
Yes, sir.
Explain. Tomar nijer language e nijer moto kore bojhao. Exact Hall voltage ta ki?
Sir, exact Hall voltage is when we keep the current carrying semiconductor perpendicular to the magnetic field. That time Lorentz force will be generated and the charge carriers will get aligned. At that time we will get the voltage. That's the Hall voltage. And the voltmeter will show the reading, that the exact value of the Hall voltage.
No, voltmeter will not show the exact value of the Hall voltage.
No, sir.
How will you adjust exact Hall voltage?
Sir, we have to subtract the zero error from the greater value.
Zero error, how will you find out the zero error of that setup?
Sir, when we
in this setup, just put the magnetic field off by anywhere. Either take the semiconductor away or just means make the magnetic fields currents, electromagnetic currents is off, at that time you just on the voltmeter reading you have to get, that will be zero voltage or zero error voltage of the reading. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Explain. Bujhao.
Sir.
Zero error voltage ta ki kore asche?
Sir, when we take the semiconductor out from the magnetic field or by putting the value of the magnetic field zero, then still also we will get a small value in the voltmeter. That's the zero error. And that we have to subtract from the hall voltage.
And what is the measured hall voltage? First of all, how will you get that hall voltage? You will give a magnetic field. You will keep your Are you sleeping?
No, sir.
Okay. So, you will just keep your, hold the piece of the semiconductor and inside the magnetic field perpendicularly, then measure the Hall voltage D. That will be give you the appeared Hall voltage. Then you will subtract that zero error voltage from that. So, up to now, how many of you have any questions regarding exact Hall voltage, appeared Hall voltage and zero error voltage? So how many of you any question regarding these three? Is it clear, all of you? Or anyone have any question? What is appeared voltage? What is exact voltage? And what is zero error voltage here? Is it clear, all of you? Or anyone have any question?
Clear, sir, clear.
Bujhe. Tale kake. Tale next question e jai. Tamanna. Is it clear? Clear. Haan? Ki bujhte parecho gota na?
Yes.
আমার সঙ্গে গলাই পড়ে যাচ্ছে না।
Yes sir.
সুমিত।
Yes sir.
So just is this clear? Now just tell me if in a non-magnetic field you are getting a Hall voltage of 10 volts. Okay, and when you are making the sweep away from the setup, you are getting a magnetic field, Hall voltage of 1 volt. So, what will be exact Hall voltage here? Sumit? Bhalo kore question ta shono. Jokhon tumi ki korecho, Hall voltage, mane chipটাকে perpendicularly magnetic field এর মধ্যে রেখেছো, তোমার ভোল্টমিটারটা 10 ভোল্ট শো করছে হল ভোল্টেজ, আর যখন তুমি ওটাকে বাইরে নিয়ে এসছো তখন ওটা 1 ভোল্ট শো করছে। হ্যাঁ, তো এক্সাক্ট হল ভোল্টেজ কত হবে বলো তো? সুমিত সুমিত শুভদীপ, what will be exact Hall voltage when you are getting a voltage of 10 volt when you are holding the piece of the semiconductor inside that electromagnet? You are getting a voltage of 10 volt. When you are taking it out, you are getting a voltage of 1 volt. So what will be exact Hall voltage? Shubhadeep?
So 9.
9 volt. Okay. 9 volt. Just subtract kore dao difference ta. Somo?
Yes sir.
Okay, you are getting a voltage of 5 volt when the magnetic field is on.
Yes.
Okay, and you are getting a voltage of 1 volt when the magnetic field is off. What will be exact Hall voltage?
4 volts.
Shorob, you are getting a voltage reading of say 10 volt when the magnetic field is on and you are getting a voltage of 1 volt, sorry, 3 volt. So what will be the reading here, exact hall voltage?
7 volts, sir.
How?
So, whole voltage we minus the error. Whole voltage is 10 volt and the error is 3 volt. So, we subtract to get the...
You are getting 7 volt. Okay. Yes, you sir. Have subtracted means 10 minus 3. What? What was 10 yes, here? What was 10 volt here?
Sir, in the magnetic 20. Field, Lorentz force. Yes, sir. Whole voltage, sir.
The whole voltage which is coming was 10 volt, okay. And when you are taking it out or magnetic field is off, you are getting a voltage of 3 volt.
Yes,
so
sir.
These 3 volt here, there is no Lorentz force, so it should show 0, but it will not show 0. 3 volt is coming. So actually, what is the whole voltage by placing your strip inside a magnetic field? How you get? You have to subtract that value.
Yes, sir.
So in a, it will the zero error the reading will vary, but the zero error value will not vary each time. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, Shilpa.
Yes, sir.
You have got a voltage of 15 volt when the magnetic field is on, and you are have getting a voltage of 6 volt when it is off, magnetic field is off. What will it be the exact hall voltage?
So 9 volt.
How?
So 15 volt that is hall voltage, and the 6 volt is zero error. That will be 6 volt is error. Usko subtract karne se mil jayega.
Why you have subtracted? What is the subtraction here? From what to what you have subtracted?
Sir, hall voltage to error.
Error voltage. What was hall voltage here? When you keep your semiconductor, current carrying semiconductor in that magnetic field. Okay. The voltage you are measuring, you want to measure that value. Okay. So what is that value? It is coming. 15 I told you, then when you are not applying that magnetic field by any way, then there should not be any voltage, hall voltage on the voltmeter, but it will show some reading, so you have subtracted this one. Nidhi, are you awake? Nidhi?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
You... You gave a voltmeter, you are measuring a value of 3 volt. Okay. And when the magnetic field is off, it's showing 0.5 volt. What is the exact hall voltage here?
So, can you repeat the question again?
When the magnetic field is on, okay, you are getting a voltage of 3 volt on the voltmeter. When the magnetic field is off, you are getting a means voltage of 0.5 volt on the voltmeter. What will be the exact value of hall voltage? Easy?
Yes, sir. Sir, this part I have not understood.
Hey, just subtract. That zero error voltage, what is zero error voltage I told? It is the 0.5 volt. How that 0.5 volt you are showing, you are getting when the magnetic field is off. Okay, there should not be any hall voltage, voltage on the hall voltage setup. So, but it's in that condition, it's showing that value. So, what does that mean? You have to subtract that 0.5 volt from that 3 volt. Okay, which earlier you are getting by putting your semiconductor inside a perpendicular magnetic field. So just subtract 0.5 volt from that 3 volt means the exact hall voltage will be 3 minus 0.5. Who will explain? Shilpa. Shilpa?
Yes, sir.
Explain, what is hall voltage?
Sir, when we have put the current carrying semiconductor perpendicular to the magnetic field, a voltage is generated, that is hall voltage.
What is Vikram?
Yes, sir.
What is hall voltage?
Sir, when we keep the current carrying semiconductor inside a magnetic field, we will get a hall voltage.
Mm-hmm. And what is zero error voltage here?
Sir, when we kept zero magnetic field setup, still some voltage will show in this voltmeter.
Okay. And how will you adjust?
Sir, we will subtract the appear voltage to the zero error voltage.
Kaushik, any question? Kaushik, Kunal, anyone have any question regarding adjustment of taking current, taking hall voltage reading? Huh? All of you clear or anyone have any question? Why that zero error will come, Pranoy? Pranoy, how that zero error voltage will come? You will measure?